ओम सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति शांति शांतिः। समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्म विद्वरम्। So yesterday we chanted the Ganga Stotram and the Saraswati Sharda Stotram. Yamunashtakam is what we have to chant today. So you will be having a file on your phone on the group called yamunashtakam.pdf. First paragraph alone you can repeat after me to get the tune, rest we will do it together. Namami Yamunamaham. Repeat. Sakala Siddhi Hetum Muda. Murari Pada Pankaja. Sfurada Mandare Nutkatam. Tatastha Navakanana. Prakatamoda Pushpambuna. Surasura Supujita. Smarapitu Shriyam Bibhratim. Kalinda Girimastake. Together. Kalinda Girimastake. Patada Mandapuro Jwala. Vilasa gamanollasat prakata ganda shailonnata sagosha gati dantura samadhi rudha dolottama mukunda rati vardhini jayati padma bandho suta bhuvam bhuvana pavani adigata maneka svanaihi priyabhirivasevitam Shukamayuraham sadibhihi taranga bhujakanana prakata muktika valuka nitamba tat sundarim namata krishna turya priyam ananta guna bhushite shiva virinchi devastute gahan Dhruva Parashara Abhishtade Vishuddha Mathura Tate Sakala Gopa Gopi Vrute Krupa Jaladi Samshrite Mama Mana Sukham Bhavaya Yaya Charana Padmaja Samagamanto Bhavat Sakala Siddhida Sevatam Taya sadrishatamiyat kamala jasa patni vayat manasi me sada sthiyatam namostu yamune sada tava charitram adyadbhutam najatu yamayatana bhavati te prayah bhagini sutan Priyo bhavati sevanat tava harir yatha gopikah amastu tava sannidhau tanunavatame tavata nadurlabhatamatratihi muraripu mukunda priye tava lalana suradhuni param sangamat tavaiva bhuvikirtita Natu kadapi pushti sthitehi Kamala jasa patni priye Harir yadanu sevaya Bhavati saukhya ma mokshatah Iyam tava kathadhika Sakala gopika sangama Smarashrama jalanubhi Sakala gatra jai sangamah मुदा पठति सूरसूते सदा समस्त दुरितक्षयो भवति वै मुकुन्दे रतिः तया सकल सिद्धयो मुररिपुश्च सन्तुष्यति स्वभावो विजयो भवेत् वदति वल्लभ श्रीहरेः। लाउडली कर बोलो।
श्याम सुंदर श्री अपने
जय
की
जय
की
जय
आज के आनंद की जय।
वेरी गुड। नाउ वी विल सिंग मधुराष्टकम बिकॉज कृष्ण भगवान इज द प्रिसाइडिंग डेटी। Madhav is the presiding deity of Prayag. So you have a file madhurashtakam.pdf. Adharam madhuram vadanam madhuram nayanam madhuram hasitam madhuram hridayam madhuram gamanam madhuram madhuradhipate rakhilam मधुरम वचनम मधुरम चरितम मधुरम वसनम मधुरम वलितम मधुरम चलितम मधुरम भ्रमितम मधुरम मधुराधिपतेरखिलम मधुरम वेणुर्मधुरो रेणुर्मधुरः पाणिर्मधुरः पादौ मधुरौ नृत्यं मधुरं सख्यं मधुरं मधुराधिपतेरखिलं मधुरं गीतं मधुरं पीतं मधुरं भुक्तं मधुरं सुप्तं मधुरं रूपं मधुरं तिलकं मधुरं मधुराधिपते अखिलं मधुरं करणं मधुरं तरणं मधुरं हरणं मधुरं स्मरणं मधुरं वमितं मधुरं शमितं मधुरं मधुराधिपतेरखिलं मधुरं गुञ्जा मधुरा माला मधुरा यमुना मधुरा वीची मधुरा सलिलं मधुरं कमलं मधुरं गोपी मधुरा लीला मधुरा युक्तं मधुरं भोक्तं मधुरं दृष्टं मधुरं श्रेष्ठं मधुरं मधुराधिपते अखिलं मधुरं गावो मधुरा यष्टिर्मधुरा श्रेष्ठिर्मधुरा दलितं मधुरं फलितं मधुरं मधुराधिपते अखिलं मधुरं मधुराधिपते अखिलं मधुरं जय जय गोविंद जय हरि गोविंद। 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 जय जय गोविंद जय हरि गोविंद 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 जय हरि गोविंद जय हरि गोविंद बोलो सर्वत्र गोविंद नाम संकीर्तनम गोविंदा गोविंदा श्री कृष्ण कन्हैया लाल की जय श्री बिंदु माधव भगवान की जय Now we sing the Prayag Ashtakam. It is in this file name called Triveni Ashtakam dash 2 and Prayag Ashtakam. That's the name of the file. It is a JPEG file. It's not a PDF file. It's a picture file. ना भाई यहाँ बैटरी ना थी कहीं बैटरी प्रयाग अष्टकम इट्स अ जेपेग फाइल गॉट इट इट्स अ पिक्चर फोटोग्राफ इट्स नॉट अ पीडीएफ फाइल You can repeat after me, the first one especially. Suramunidhiti jendraihi Sevyate yostatandraihi Guru taraduritanam Kakatha manavanam Sabhuvi sukruta kartuhu Vanchita vapti hetuhu Jayati vijaya Jayati vijitaya agaha Tirtharaja prayagaha This tune is different now. Shruti Pramanam Smritaya Pramanam Puranam Apyatra Param Pramanam Yatrasti Ganga Yamuna Pramanam Satirtha Rajo Jayati Prayagaha Nayatra Yoga Charana Pratiksha Nayatra Yagneshti Vishishti Diksha Nataraka Jnana Guru Rapesha Satirtha Rajo Jayati Prayagaha Chiram Nivasam Nasamikshateyo Yudara Charitas Pradadati Kaman Yakkalpitarthascha Dadati Pumsam Satirtha Rajo Jayati Prayagaha Tirthavali Yasya Tukanta Bhage Da ज्ञानावलि वल्गति पादमूले व्रतावलि दक्षिण बाहुमूले सतीर्थराजो जयति प्रयागः यत्राप्लुतानां नयमो नियन्ता. On the side, right side it is, on the top. Yatra sthitanam sugati pradata. Yatra ashritanam amrita pradata. Satirtha rajo jayati prayagaha. Sita site yatra taranga chamare. नद्यौ विभाते मुनि भानुकल्यके नीलातपत्रं वट एव साक्षात् सतीर्थराजो जयति प्रयागः पुर्यः सप्त प्रसिद्धा. This tune is different. This is like the first shloka. सप्त प्रसिद्धा पतिवचन रतास्तीर्थराजस्य नार्यः प्रसिद्धा पतिवचन रतास्तीर्थराजस्य नार्यः नैकट्यो नातिहृद्या प्रभवति च गुणैः काशते ब्रह्म यस्याम् काशते ब्रह्म यस्याम् सेयं राज्ञी प्रधाना प्रियवचनकरी मुक्तिदाने नियुक्ता येन ब्रह्माण्डमध्ये सजयति सुतरां तीर्थराजप्रयागः इति श्रीमत्स्यपुराणे प्रयागाष्टकं समाप्तम्. See, these all are there in our Puranas, but many times we don't know only that these are there. Kaha se aaye? Oh, our own havan ka. Prasad we are getting. Basma is flying everywhere now. After Prayagashtakam. Okay, so I have also sent you Bharat prays to Prayag. It's a JPEG image. Bharat prays to Prayag, part 1 and part 2. Oh, oh, jo us din bheja tha na sab. Mela? Bharat prays to Prayag. That's the name of the file. JPEG. Nahi hai.
Follow up. 1 minute.
Okay, now I will put it on the group. You can check your WhatsApp, it will come now. Okay, so now it will come in 2 minutes. Part 1 and part 2. Okay. Yeah, page 378 is first one and then the second one after that. Okay, so you can repeat after me. We have to start from Doha onwards. Just now I've said now only. Bharat tisare paharakaha kina prabesu prayaga kahata ramasiya ramasiya umagagi umagi umagi anuraga. So it said that in the third prayer Bharat entered Prayag. So prayer means 3 hours. One prayer is 3 hours. 8 prayer becomes 1 day. So 12 to 3, 1. Then 3 to 6, 1. 6 to 9, 1. 9 to 12, 1. Like this, 8 times. So in the third prayer, Bharat entered Prayag in the morning. And when he entered Prayag, how did he enter with the bhav? Kahata Ramasiya Ramasiya. He was saying the name of the Lord, Ram and Sita, Ram and Sita, and he entered. Umagi Umagi Anurag. There's a lot of devotion rising in his heart. Why? Because see, now, right now, Bharatji is going to meet Bhagwan Ram to call him back. What is written here is, he goes with him, all the Ayodhya Vasis are there. The three mothers are there, other queens of Dasharatha Maharaj are there, and Vasishtha Rishi is there, Sumantra is there, everybody is going to bring Ramji back. So, in this, before he enters Prayag, he has sent everybody in the front, and he is walking barefoot behind. He doesn't go on the chariot, because if Bhagwan is walking barefoot, how can he go on chariot? That is his bhav. And where all Bhagwan has gone, when he goes there, he becomes full of bhav and devotion. So earlier where he has met Nishad Raj, Nishad Raj showed him ki, you know, on this floor, on this leaf, Bhagwan has slept whole night here. And this is where he came, this is where we gave him food. So every place he goes, he bows down there. Now, Bhagwan is in Chitrakut. So, before he goes to Chitrakut, from Ayodhya, he comes here, then he goes to Chitrakut. So, on the way when he comes to Prayag, he knows that Bhagwan has come here. So, his heart is filled with that joy and the devotion. Then what does he do? Then the Chaupai starts. Jhalaka jhalaka tapayana kaise pankaja kosa osakana jaise bharata payo dehi aaye aaju bhayau dukhita suni sakala samaju. So here it is said that jhalaka jhalakata payana kaise. Pankaja kosa osa kana jaise. You know, there are blisters on his feet. And on those blisters, the shine of that blisters is like the dew drop on the lotus. Now there are blisters on his feet because he is a prince. He has not walked like this barefoot before, and nobody knows that he is walking behind on barefoot. So when they come to know, Bharat payo dehi aaye aaju bhayo dukhita suni sakala samaju. When they heard that whole day Bharat has walked only on barefoot, many people were distressed. Khabari leena sab loga nahaye kinha pranamo trivenihi aaye. Sabidhi sita sita nari nahane nira nahane diye dana mahi surasana mane. Khabari leeni sab loga nahaye. First he found out that whether everybody has taken bath. See, he is a devotee as well as he is a leader at this moment, because he is leading everybody. So he ensured that everybody has taken bath. Then kina pranamo triveni hi aaye. Then he does pranam, does the snan on triveni. Savidhi sita sita nira nahane. He took the bath as per the tradition. And then diye dan mahisura sanmane. Then he gave dan to the brahmanas. Dekhata syamala dhavala halore pulaki sarira bharata karajore sakala kama pradati ratharao beda vidita jaga pragata prabhao mangau bhikha tyagi nija dharmo arata kahana karai kukaramo asajiya jani sujana sudani safala karahi jaga jachakabani. So he says, Dekhata syamala dhavala halore. When he saw the waves, white and black, he must have seen both the rivers meeting. So when he saw that, then pulaki sarira bharata karajore. He had horripilations on his body and he folded his hands and he is praying to Prayagraj. Sakala kama prada tirath rao. Oh Prayagraj, you are fulfiller of all people's, all desires. Veda vidita jaga pragata prabhavu. All the Vedas also sing your glory and the whole world knows what is your glory. He says, Mangau bhikha tyagi nija dharmo. He says, I beg you, leaving my dharma. Meaning what? A kshatriya doesn't beg. Bhiksha is asked by the brahmana, brahmachari, sannyasi. But kshatriya doesn't ask for bhiksha. He doesn't ask for. So he says, I am leaving all that and I am literally begging you. What is he begging? Arata kahana karai kukaramo. He says that when somebody is afflicted, what will they not do to remove that affliction? Right now Bharat is afflicted with what? Ram viraha. Bhagwan Ram has gone away. And who is the cause for that? He is thinking he is the cause. Kere, my mother did this for me. And she wanted the kingdom for me. And she wanted the kingdom for me, that is one thing. But why did she have to send Ram away for 14 years? So he is continuously feeling very guilty that because of me now Bhagwan is in the forest. So he is afflicted. So he is asking Prayagraj that, you know, anybody who is afflicted, what will they not do? They will not remain in their dharma. So now I am begging you, asajiya jani sujana sudani. Realizing this, safala karahi jaga jachakabani. Realizing this, the wise and the generous people will fulfill the desire of the afflicted to remove that person from the sorrow. Now the next doha is something which one should memorize. If one can memorize, just memorize it. This is the bhava of Bharatji that he is asking Prayagraj, what is his prayer, you see? Artha na dharma na kama ruchi gati na chahu nirbana janam janam rati rama pada yah baradanu na ana. Together, Artha na dharma na kama ruchi gati na chahu nirbana janam janam rati rama pada yah baradanu na ana. Siyavar Ramachandra ki jai, Pavan Suta Hanuman ki jai, Umapati Mahadev ki jai, Bolo Bhai Sab Santan ki jai. What does he pray to Prayagraj? He says, Artha, the first Purushartha we seek is Artha. We want to be physically secure, financially secure, socially secure. Artha we want. Our culture never condemns wealth. Many people think if you come to spirituality, they will say, ye sab kya hai, ye sab moh maya hai, ye sab chhod do. You know, Artha is the first pursuit of human being. But how we use that Artha is our choice. We use it for doing punya, we use it for doing satsang, we use it for serving the people. So he says, generally people ask these four. So he says, first one is Artha. He says, I don't want Artha. Artha. Then he says, Dharma. He says, I don't want Dharma also. Now, by Dharma here doesn't mean duties. By Dharma here doesn't mean values. By Dharma here means all those actions doing which one gets punya, and getting punya one goes to heaven. He says, I am not interested in heaven, in getting punya. Then says, kam na kama ruchi. No interest even in sense enjoyments. Because Artha one wants for kama, for enjoying life. To go here, go there, enjoy, eat this, see that. One has desires, senses are also wanting it. So Artha is required for kama. He says, I don't want Artha, I don't want kama, I don't want dharma also. Then someone says, at least you want moksha, because if none of these three you want, then moksha you want. He says, gatina chahahu nirvan. I don't even want nirvan, I don't want moksha. See, here is the glory of bhakti. Bhakti is considered greater than moksha also. Moksha is freedom from cycle of birth and death. But the devotee says, I don't want freedom from cycle of birth and death. If Bhagwan wants to send me back into the world, I will come. But only one condition. I don't mind taking birth again and again. And this is not an ordinary thing. You imagine to take birth is a pain. And which yoni we will take birth? Many people think once a human, always a human. Shastra doesn't give that guarantee. Some people have just assumed it on their own. Shastra says, yatha karma, yatha shrutam. Kathopanishad says that. One will get the birth according to one's karma and according to one's knowledge. Yatha karma, yatha shrutam. So it's not necessary that we will all get human birth only again. But to evolve consciously, yes, after whatever yonis one goes through, again one comes back to human birth. So which yoni one will get birth, that one doesn't know. Taking birth itself is a pain. We congratulate the parent, you know, the child is born. But the pain for the mother and the pain for the child, no child comes out smiling. All the children, when they come out, first thing they do is what? Cry. Shankaracharya ji wrote one composition called Shiva Pradha Kshamapana Stotram. There he describes the sorrow of every stage of life and how we have forgotten Bhagavan in that stage. So it is said that when the child is in the womb, excruciating pain it has. Why it came into the womb? Adav karma prasangat kalayati kaluksham matra kukshav sthitam mam. The child has come into the womb of the mother because of what? Some karma of the past. Vin mutra metra madhye kothayati nitaram. Jatharo Jata Veda is surrounded by urine, fecal matter, and the Jataragni of the mother. Right now, little bit of sun and we are boiling. Jataragni, 9 months we have got roasted inside there. And now if there is no light in the room, we say, no, current nahi hai. Battery lao, torch lao, electricity chalu karo, generator lao. Udhar kaun sa generator tha? Internet to tha hi nahi udhar. Accommodation ka bhi problem tha. Now we ask, how will be the accommodation in Prayag, Swamiji? Udhar kaun sa bed tha? We are lying like that, ulta that also. And if one lady recently gave birth to 12 children. 12. Huh? 12, yeah. You just imagine inside what is the accommodation. 12 of them must be like that, sitting ulta. Vapre. Vinmutra medhya madhya kvathayati nitaram jataro jata veda. In that pain, one thinks, this is enough now. He says, when I come out, I am not going to, you know, the jiva in there prays to Bhagwan, saying, Bhagwan, this pain, I don't want to come back again. When I come out, I will definitely remember you. I forgot you the last whole life, that's why I'm landed up here. 9 months that jiva is constantly thinking, this is my last birth, I don't want birth. When he comes out after that, I don't want moksha, I want everything else. See, that's the power of Maya, how it is. It is said that the child cries. You know why the child cries? Doctor will say that the child cries because, you know, you cut the umbilical cord and then the first breath. And if the child doesn't cry, they'll tap the child, cry. You know, because the lungs have to expand or whatever. But philosophically we say the child cries because, alas, Bhagwan, your Maya has touched me now and I am going to forget you and again I will have to be born again. That's why the child cries. And through the whole life also, Bhagwan keeps giving reminders in the form of dukkha, pain. And he wrote in the Gita also, anityam asukham lokam. This loka is anitya, there is no permanent happiness here. And even that sukha we experience is not real sukha. Anityam asukham lokam. See, suppose the creator of this iPhone. Now the creator of this iPhone says, this is possible by the iPhone, this is not possible. Like this iPhone right now cannot handle 5G network. What will you and I do? Can we say that, are tum to pagal hai, it will handle 5G network, let me try it. Can we do that? We will accept, no, nahi, it will not work. Creator of the universe is telling us, there is no sukha in the world. But what are we saying? Are hoga wo tum apne paas rakho apna gyan. I am to going to find sukha in this only. Bhagwan says, this is dukkhalay. The word for samsara, what Bhagwan has told in the Gita? Dukkhalay. Dukkhalayam ashashvatam. There is no dukkha here. So Gurudev used to tell very nicely. He used to say the main course is dukkha. Sukha is like a chutney. We want the ulta, no? We want sukha. Dukkha comes now and then. But the real fact is what? This is dukkhalay only. So why to come back again here? But look at the devotee. The devotee says, I don't mind going through all this pain in the womb of the mother and still coming into this dukkhalay. If you bless me, that I will not forget you. Bas. Janama janama rati rama pada. Every life I should remember you and I should have supreme devotion to your lotus feet. Yaha varadanuna an. Meaning, he is praying to Prayagraj that, oh Prayagraj, I don't want dharma, I don't want artha, I don't want kama, I don't want moksha. Then what do I want? Bless me with the constant remembrance of the name of the Lord and that bhakti. This is called aviral bhakti, ananya bhakti, vimal bhakti. And this bhakti, if somebody has, you know, Bhagwan also doesn't give this bhakti very soon. Because if bhakti, if this bhakti anybody has, Bhagwan runs after that person. Bhagwan becomes the servant as though of that person. Bhagwan says, I will serve that devotee. Bharatji is not doing it to get Bhagwan to become his sevak. Bharatji is doing it because he genuinely loves the Lord. He doesn't want anything else. Vairagya of Bharatji is tremendous. See, Lakshmanji's Vairagya is one thing. But Lakshmanji was always with Bhagwan Ram. Continuously for 14 years. Because Bhagwan Ram knows that Lakshman cannot survive without him. So he took him with him into the forest. But Bharatji's Bhakti and Vairagya is another level. He is 14 years away from Bhagwan. And he lives away in the forest. Full of devotion. I mean, he lives away from the kingdom in the Nandigram. And full time the mind is only thinking of Bhagwan. And when he went to meet Bhagwan now, he told Bhagwan also, if 1 minute extra you take, I will jump into the fire. 14 years, you cannot take more than 1 minute extra. I mean, you cannot take 1 minute extra. And Bhagwan was conscious. Imagine after 14 years, you and I may forget also. कि हमको ये टाइम पे पहुंचना है भगवान सेंट हनुमान जी सेइंग कि हनुमान आई एम बिजी इन दिस लंका राइट नाउ आई मे टेक पुष्पक एंड कम बट बिफोर दैट यू गो यू टेल भरत दैट आई एम कमिंग बिकॉज ही इज वेरी पक्का इफ हिज वर्ड वट एवर ही टेल्स ही विल डू इट सो ही सेज यू टेल हिम टू वेट आई एम जस्ट कमिंग सो हनुमान जी गोस सो दिस इज द भरत दिस इज द भक्ति ऑफ भरत जी एंड ही सेज ओ प्रयागराज Please bless me with this kind of a devotion to the Lord. Now, if this type of a devotion we have, we need nothing in life. Even if we are born again, you know, some devotees have said, even if I have to be born as a stone, may I be born in the Yamuna. You know, as a stone on the banks of Yamuna, where Krishna can play on me. I think it's a Muslim devotee who wrote this whole thing. Ras Khan or somebody, I think. He says, if I have to be a tree, let me be the Kadamba tree. If I have to be a crocodile, let me be a crocodile in the Yamuna. No, I don't mind any yoni. As long as I am associated full time with the Lord. So, in bhakti and even in jnana, moksha is not freedom from cycle of birth and death. Because birth and death is not a problem. Ignorance is the problem. When I don't know who am I misunderstand myself to be one little jiva, and then this jiva thinks of itself as finite and then wants happiness from the world outside. Vismriti, forgetfulness, is the cause. In bhakti we say vismriti and in jnana we say avidya. If you see Narad Bhakti Sutra, what pains a devotee maximum? Not only separation. Separation Bharat has dealt with. Separation has a pain, but more painful than separation is forgetfulness. Tad vismarane parama vyakulata. If I forget Bhagwan, it should pain me. Then I am a devotee. That's the quality of a devotee. Ananya bhakta, that person is called. That person will never forget Bhagwan. You know, Arjun was one of the ananya bhaktas of the Lord. We think Arjun only as a warrior. But Arjun was Ananya Bhakta of the Lord to such an extent that every moment of his breath, inhalation, exhalation is only Krishna, 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 Krishna. One story comes where, you know, he was sleeping and the rhythm of the breath is the sound of Krishna. Krishna is reverberating from his body. Narajji comes there and some other people come there and they all start, you know, playing the cymbal and the tanpura and everything and they all are doing kirtan there. Just the breathing of Arjuna is not chanting. He is an ananya bhakta of Bhagwan. So such ananya bhaktas, Bharatji is like that. See, 14 years he was away from the Lord, but full time thinking only of Bhagwan. So that is the devotion and that devotion is what one seeks. So when we come to Prayagraj, this is what Bharatji has asked. One can also pray that if one wants, that Bhagwan, please bless me with constant remembrance. Then wherever I am, whichever condition I am, whatever is the situation, it doesn't matter. But if Bhagwan's name we don't know, we don't remember. Whatever be the condition outside, we may be in great luxury, we may be in great, facility, comfort. It is of no use because it's all temporary. It will only increase our bondage. So this is the prayer of Bharatji. One thing. Then the second part. Now Bharatji is telling Prayagraj. See, this is the conversation they are having. That's why I'm saying we think that Prayag is only a place. But Prayagraj is a deity also. So he's telling Prayagraj that what he is feeling. See the second file. Janahu Rama Kutila Karimohi Loga Kahau Guru Sahiba Drohi Sita Rama Charanarati More Anudina Badhau Anugrahatore. He says, Janahu Rama Kutila Kari Mohi. May Ram, Ram may think that I am Kutil. Why he is saying like that? Because of the guilt, that because of me, it must be my ambition that my mother has asked such a boon. So Ram may think like that, Bharat is such a Kutil person. He says, may Ram think like that. May all the people also say that I am a Drohi to my Guru. Log kahau Guru Sahib Drohi. Meaning, what did the Guru teach you? And what are you doing? Guru taught you to serve the Lord and you have sent the Lord into the forest. So people may talk like that. Ye kaisa Guru Drohi hai? He said, people may talk like that. Ram himself may think I am Kutil. But what is my prayer to you, O Prayagraj? Sita Ram Charan Rati More. I want only the devotion to the lotus feet of Sita Ramji. Anudina Badhau, and it should grow day by day. Dina means day, Anu means continuous. Anudina, day by day, every day, continuously that devotion must increase. That's the beauty. He is not asking one day, give me full devotion, khatam. He says, day, my devotion should go on increasing. Anugrahatore, by your grace. So he is asking Prayagraj, please bless me with that. Jaladu janam bhari surati bisarau jachata jalupabi pahana darau chatakuratani ghate ghati jai bade premu sab bhati bhalai. So this chatak bird keeps on looking at the moon and it will drink the rain water only when there is Swati Nakshatra. It may be very thirsty and it may be raining also, but it will not drink unless that Swati Nakshatra happens and then the rain happens, that water that chatak bird will drink. So here he says, Jaladu Janam Bhari Surati Bisarau. So this chatak bird, all its life may be neglected by the clouds. And when the chatak bird prays that may the rain happen in the Swati Nakshatra, the cloud may throw thunderbolt. Chataku Ratani Ghate Ghati Jai Bade Prem Sab Bhanti Bhalai. So that cloud may discharge a thunderbolt and hailstones, but the bird will not stop calling out to the cloud. The cloud may do anything. The bird will not stop calling out to the cloud that please rain during that Swati Nakshatra and keeps on staring at the clouds. In the same way, whatever the people may think, I will not stop asking you, O Prayagraj, that bless me with more and more devotion. Kanaka hi baana chadhai jimidahe timi priyatam apadane manibahe Bharata bachana sunimaja tribeni भई मृदु बानी सुमंगल देने। सो इट सेज कनक ही बाण चढ़ई जिमी दाहे, दाहे मीन्स टू बर्न, व्हेन दैट गोल्ड इज पुट इन द फायर देन इट बर्न्स एंड इट गेट्स प्यूरिफाइड। तिमि प्रियतम पद नेम निबाहे, इन द सेम वे व्हेन आई स्टिक टू द name of the Lord and devotion to his feet, I get more and more purified. So he says, Bharat bachan suni maaj tribeni. So Tirtharaj and Triveni, listening to Bharatji, they respond. The sweet words of Bharatji, when they heard, they respond. Bhai mrudu bani sumangala deni. What did they tell Bharatji? Tat Bharat tuma sab vidhi sadhu, रामचरण अनुराग अगाधु, बादी गलानी करहु मन माही, तुम सम राम ही को प्रिय नाही। वेरी नाइस रिप्लाई ही गिव्स। सो तीर्थराज एंड त्रिवेणी दे टेल हिम, तात भरत तुम सब विधि साधु, ओ भरत जी यू आर ए साधु, यू आर साधु लिटल मीन्स गुड पर्सन। Sadhu doesn't mean only a sannyasi. If you eat good food, you want to praise your spouse who has made some nice new dish, and you can tell sadhu sadhu. If somebody is wearing good clothes, you have to appreciate them, you can say sadhu sadhu. Sadhu means good. So he says, Bharatji, you are already a very good person. Don't blame yourself, don't condemn yourself. In the Gita also Bhagavan says, Uddhared Atmana Atmanam, lift yourself by yourself, don't condemn yourself. He says, don't think so bad about yourself, you are a sadhu purush. Ram Charano Anuraga Agadhu, and you already have unlimited devotion for Bhagavan Ram's feet. Badi Galani Karahu Manamahi, in vain you are just entertaining depressive thoughts. Tum Sam Priya, Tum Sam Ramahi Ko Priya Nahi. There is nobody who is as dear to Ram as you. Bharatji heard that and he was so happy. He was not happy when he says, you are a sadhu purush. He said, okay, theek hai. But when he said, nobody is as dear to you, nobody is as dear to Ram as you, then he is happy. Now just think, given in Hanuman Chalisa, Tulsidasji has written what about Hanumanji? तुम ममस प्रिय भरत ही सम भाई। राम जी टेलिंग हनुमान जी दैट यू आर डियर टू मी लाइक माय भरत। भरत जी भगवान राम कंसिडर्स भरत एज द सुप्रीम डिवोटी एंड ही इक्वेट्स हनुमान जी ऑल्सो टू भरत जी बिकॉज व्हेन हनुमान जी कम्स बैक फ्रॉम लंका with the news of Sitaji, he tells Hanumanji, I don't know what to do. How will I repay you back? And when they all go back after the war to Ayodhya and the Rajyabhishek happens of Bhagwan, Bhagwan gives gifts to everybody, Sugriv and Vibhishan and Angad and everybody, Bhagwan is giving gifts. And he doesn't give anything to Hanumanji. Sita is looking at Bhagavan Ram saying, what are you doing? You know, sometimes the closest person who is there, you forget that person only. Not intentionally, because there is so much of love, you forget. This vote of thanks, no, is very difficult to do. Many times we forget that very person who has worked maximum, because he's like a part of, you have constantly thought about that person doing work, this, that. When you have to do vote of thanks, no, you write formally, this thank, this thank, this. That person who has worked, you forget sometimes. So Sitaji thought maybe Bhagavan Ram forgot in the tension of so many people here to felicitate. He says, you give something to Hanuman. He says, what can I give to Hanuman? I have already given myself to him. He has made me so indebted that anything I give him is not possible to give out, reduce the debt that he has put me in. So I am indebted to him. Imagine Bhagwan is indebted to Hanumanji. He says, forever I am indebted to him. What can I give him? So he just goes and gives him one hug. So that is the thing here. He says, Tum sama Rama hi ko priya nahi. There is nobody as dear as you are to Bhagwan Ram. So when Bharatji heard this, then he was satisfied. We'll do one more doha and stop. Tanu puloke uhi. Sorry, that tune is gone. Tanu puloke uhi harshu suni. Beni bachana anukula. Bharat dhanya kahi dhanya sura. Harashita barachahi phula. Tanapulakeu, his body had her horripilations. Here Harashu suni, and his mind was filled with so much of joy. Beni bachan anukul, listening to. Beni means Triveni, Prayagraj, and Triveni Sangam. Bharat dhanya kahi dhanya sura. Devatas, they praise Bharatji and they offer barachahi phul. That is one standard job of devatas. They stand up, keep putting flowers. Especially when Bhagavan takes avatar, they are always ready with one flower tokri. Wherever Bhagavan is there, they go and stand and they keep putting flowers. So this is the prasang of Bharatji and how he prays to Prayagraj. And you see the bhav of his, na, that Bhagavan has come to Prayagraj. So for him, it is doubly purified. Prayag by itself is a great Tirtha. And then Bhagwan has come and already sanctified it. Then he comes to Tirthraj Prayag and he is asking Prayagraj. See, already he is a devotee. He already has devotion. Still he is asking Tirthraj Prayag that please bless me with. Why is that so? Because our mind, you know, is just unpredictable. When this mind will flip, no idea. Also, when our punya karma gets over, we don't know. So we may feel now I am a great devotee. Ho gaya. That itself is the ego. To say that now I don't need devotion means, is it devotion? Ego came, na? How can there be enough devotion for infinite Lord? Bas ho gaya abhi. 10 pound hai devotion, bas khatam. Abhi usse zyada nahi chahiye. Some people say like that, you know, sab kuch limit mein hona chahiye Swamiji. Atishay kuch bhi nahi karna chahiye. Devotion bhi limit mein, jnan bhi limit mein, seva bhi limit mein, sab kuch thoda 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 thoda. Assorted sweet ka packet hota hai na, ek jalebi, ek kachori, ek, what is that, kaju katli, like that, thoda limit mein. Assorted. Like that, thoda ye, thoda ye, thoda ye. Devotee will never stop asking for devotion. Ki, aray, please. Because this mind is absolutely unpredictable. How many lives we have lived? Which samskar will come out when? What it will make us do? We have no idea. So go on asking Bhagwan, bless me with the devotion for your lotus feet. And what type of devotion? Ananya bhakti, aviral bhakti, vimal bhakti. Three. They have one only, three words. Ananya bhakti means constant remembrance of the Lord. And Bhagavan has given that assurance in the Gita. Ananya chintayanto mam ye jana paryupasate tesham nityabhayuktanam yoga kshemam vamyam. Bhagavan will take care of the yoga and kshema of that devotee. One doesn't have to think of anything else. Remember the Lord. Every single moment. You know, one of the things to be done when we come to Tirtha is to take a sankalpa and go that we will remember the Lord throughout the day. So one of the Shastra, you know, when I was reading in this, there's a whole book called Tirtha Ank, which is brought out by Gita Press. In that, this I was reading, what should be done in Tirtha Yatra. In that they have written that take a sankalpa and go that I will remember Bhagwan 21,600 times. Every day. That 21,600 is what actually? That is that number of seconds through the day. So that 21,600 means every single moment I should remember the Lord. Now how to do that? By practice and by bhav. So one is physically I have to sit down and or exclusively sit down and do sadhana where I say I will do this many malas of japa. And rest of the time, whatever I am doing, I remember the Lord and do with the bhav that I am doing this as a seva to the Lord. Then through the day, I am remembering the Lord. And this 21,600, if you divide by 2, we will get how much? Calculator do? 10,800 you will get. 10,800 mein se 2 zero nikal do? 108. That is how we get 108. 108 is supposed to be the minimum unit of what we remember the Lord, so that we will reach 21,600. What people tell us, ek mala kiya to bas hai kya? That is one unit, so that I will remember the Lord. My goal is from 108 to 21,600. That is the goal. So one has to take that sankalpa and go that I will remember Bhagwan throughout the day. That is called Ananya Bhakti. Aviral Bhakti means unbroken. Our Bhakti should not be broken. Many times worldly desires, enjoyments, all that will come in between. From there one has to come to Aviral Bhakti. See, Prahlad ji is aviral bhakti. The father is trying to kill him with all the methods, but his mind doesn't go away from the Lord. And there is vimal bhakti. Hanuman ji, symbol of ananya bhakti. Prahlad ji, symbol of aviral bhakti. And vimal bhakti. Devotion which is free from all impurities. No selfishness in it. Only purest form of love for the Lord, for the sake of the Lord. I'll tell you one very nice point. Akhandananji Maharaj said, asking for moksha from Bhagwan is like asking for pension. When will you get pension? You have worked for so long, now you have to be taken care of after you have retired. Then you get pension. So the devotee who has done so much sadhana, to take care of the devotee, Bhagwan says, the devotee is saying, please give me moksha. So that's why he says that a real devotee doesn't ask for moksha, because it's like asking pension for all the work that I did. So I don't want moksha also. What do I want? I want only vimal bhakti, ananya bhakti, aviral bhakti. So that is a prayer to Tirtharaj Prayag, that may Bhagwan bless all of us with vimal bhakti, ananya bhakti and bhakti as a pancham purushat. If this becomes our sutra, to the doha to guide in our life, everything else will just follow. Life becomes fulfilled when there is this type of devotion. And this type of devotion is called para bhakti, supreme devotion, which is equal to atmajnan. Such a devotee, Bhagwan says in the Gita, dadami buddhi yogam tam. Because you may say that, are our problem was avidya, not birth and death. How will avidya go if I keep doing only devotion to Bhagwan? Devotion as dvaita, you know, he is separate, I am separate. How? Bhagwan blesses that person with atmajnan. Dadami buddhi yogam tam yena mam upayantite. Then the devotee becomes one with the Lord. Jnan comes. Jnan is not intellectual information. Jnan is intuitive. And Bhagwan's grace only brings that jnan to us. Our effort can only do little bit. The grace of Bhagwan brings. So he says, dadami buddhi yogam tam. Yesham satata yuktanam, tesham satata yuktanam, bhajatam priti purvakam, dadami buddhi yogam tam, yena mam upayantite. Satata yuktanam, those who are constantly striving to unite with me, to such devotees, I bless them with knowledge. So God's grace and Pujya Gurudev's blessings that we could all come here to Tirtharaj Prayag, and may the Lord bless us all. May the Tirtharaj Prayag and Triveni bless us all with this aviral bhakti and may that flow in our heart constantly. We'll chant the name of the Lord and then we will conclude. Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Ram Om. 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 Clap everybody. Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Ram Om. 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 Jaya Jaya Ram Om. Jaya Jaya Ram Om. Bolo Siyavara Ramachandra ki. Pavana Suta Hanuman ki. Umapati Mahadev ki. Bolo Bhai Sab Santan ki. Shri Sadgurunath Maharaj ki. Tirthraj Prayag ki. You know, our body is like a tree. If you go near a tree where there are a lot of birds and if you clap, what happens? Birds will fly, no? So it said our body is like the tree and the birds of sins are all sitting on this body. When you take the name of Bhagwan and you clap, then what happens? They all fly. And where do they go? To those people who are not clapping. That's why I said in between, ki clap everybody. Nahi to dusron ke sin aap leke jaoge instead of becoming purified. Chalo. Om. Yeah, I'll tell you the plan. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.